Good morning. Let's confess together right now and acknowledge Jesus is my Lord. Jesus is Lord over my family. Jesus is Lord over the United States. Jesus is Lord over our government. And Jesus is Lord over all the nations in Jesus' name. Before I minister the word this morning, I wanted to introduce you to someone. This is the newest addition of our family. His name is, can you say hello to them, huh? His name is Hunter Remington. And one day I was holding him when he was just a few days old, maybe actually 2 or 3 weeks old. And I said, you know what? I said, Pops would have said, I got me another preacher boy. And he just broke out in the biggest grin. So he is, even at a young age, full of the wisdom of God and full of the Spirit of God. Yes, he is. And he is the best baby. We prayed for him to be a great baby because she's got a 2-year-old and a 1-year-old. And we prayed for him to be a good sleeper. We prayed for him to be peaceful and a good nurser. Are you going to talk to them? Huh? You can talk to them? Yeah, of course you are. See, he's preaching already. And he is everything that we prayed for. So I encourage you, if your children or if you are expecting a baby, pray over every detail because God will do exceeding abundantly above all we can ask or think. So this was his first sermon. Yeah, it was. Okay. I thought y'all would enjoy meeting him. So we're looking at the Word of God, your most valuable possession. And I'm going to give you a reason today why the Word of God is your most valuable possession. In 1 Peter 1:23, the Holy Spirit says, being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible, by the Word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. I'm going to read that again. Being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible, by the Word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. Then he said, for all flesh is as grass, and all the glory of man as the flower of grass. The grass withereth, and the flower thereof fadeth away. But the word of the Lord endureth forever. And this is the word which by the gospel, the good news, is preached unto you. You know, I'm sure this is true of many of you as it was of me, that I was born again when I was a teenager. Actually, I joined the church when I was younger, but I joined the church because my friend joined the church. And I didn't know about being born again. So when I was about 16, 17 years old, I was in a revival at our church, and the minister was preaching on Almost Persuaded. And the Holy Spirit had already been drawing me, but hearing that word took root in my heart. And I was born again from death unto life. That word, I was born again by the Spirit of God, by the Word of God. So, but it wasn't until years later that I understood the process, actually, only by the Word of God. So I want to explain this to you so that you can get an understanding like I had to have an understanding. Because, you know, I've heard ministers say, well, there is more than one way to get to heaven. No, there's not. There's only one way, and that is through Jesus, by the Word of God. So what the process was, is the Holy Spirit drew you, and someone preached the word of God to you about salvation, about being born again. And then that word took root in your heart, that incorruptible seed of the Word of God went into your ears, down into your heart. And do you know Satan or no demon could stop that because it was the incorruptible seed of the Word of God. Again, it went in your ears, it got down in your heart, and then you received Jesus as your Lord. Well, this is not exactly where I was planning on going, but the Word also says, as you received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk ye in Him. But we were born again. The Word is very plain. We were born again by hearing the good news, by hearing the gospel of our salvation. And then that Word went in our heart, and we received it, and we confessed Jesus as Lord, and we were born. I'm telling you, the greatest miracle, from death unto life. And God gave us an inheritance. It says He turned them from darkness to light, from the power of Satan to the power of God, that we might receive inheritance and forgiveness of sins. Saints, this is the only way a person is born again and goes into heaven to be with the Father. It is the only way that you can go into the throne room is being born again. So remember that. And when you're sharing with other people, remember it's the Word that you are sharing with them that will take root in their heart. It's not your good lifestyle. It's not anything that you do. It's only the Word of God. We'll pick up on this tomorrow. Remember all day and confess this. Jesus is Lord. Praise God for the power of the Word and that it is working mightily in me, in Jesus' name.